Hello, today we will discuss about PN junction diode. In this lecture, I will cover the formation of depletion layer, space charge and electric field at junction. I will also discuss about depletion width and depletion capacitance, minority carrier distribution and current voltage characteristic of PN junction diode. Finally, I will discuss about two mechanisms, Zener and avalanche breakdown. PN junction diode. The most important characteristic of PN junction diode is that they rectify. That means current conduction is only in one direction. If you change the polarity, current is almost zero. You can see the schematic diagram of PN junction. So we have P-type semiconductor material and N-type semiconductor material. And here in the below, you can see the circuit diagram. When we apply forward bias to the junction, the current increases rapidly as the voltage increases. However, when we apply a reverse bias, virtually no current flows initially. And here in the right hand side diagram, you can see the current versus voltage plot. So, in the forward bias means we are applying positive bias on P-type semiconductor and negative bias on N-type semiconductor. So, here current increases drastically, but in reverse bias, we are changing the polarity. We are applying negative bias on P-type semiconductor and positive bias on N-type semiconductor. So, almost current conduction is zero. Now, I will come on the band diagram. Here in figure A, you can see the energy band diagram of isolated P-type and N-type semiconductor as we have discussed previously. When the P and N-type semiconductor are joined together, the large carrier concentration gradients at the junction cause carrier diffusion. Holes from P side diffuse into N side and electron from the N side into P side. As holes continue to leave the P side, some of negative acceptor ions near the junction are left uncompensated. Since the acceptor are fixed in the semiconductor lattice, whereas the holes are mobile. Similarly, some of positive donor ions near the junction are left uncompensated as the electron leave the N side. A negative space charge forms near the P side of the junction and a positive space charge forms near the N side. Here in figure B, you can see the space charge region near to P side and near to N side. Now, I will come on equilibrium Fermi levels. So, when we join these two semiconductors, how Fermi level is changing, this one is constant. Here, we can derive the mathematically. At thermal equilibrium, net holes current density is zero because we have not applied any external bias. So, total hole currents is zero and total electron current is also zero. So, here we can write Jp equal to Jp drift plus Jp diffusion, and we have derived this equation. Jp equal to Q mu p p e is the electric field minus Q dp dp upon dx. Dp is here diffusion coefficient and this one is equal to 0. So, electric field we can write 1 upon Q d e I upon dx. EI is the intrinsic Fermi level in semiconductor. Substituting the expression for hole concentration, P equal to NI exponential EI minus EF upon KT and its derivative, if you will substitute in current density equation, we will get JP equal to mu PP DEF upon DX equal to 0. Since mobility and concentration, this one is not 0. So, dEF upon dx equal to 0. Similarly, we can derive for electron current density, and here we will get dEF upon dx equal to 0. That means our Fermi level is constant with distance. So, when we are joining both semiconductors, our Fermi level is constant. Here I will discuss about the space charge distribution and built-in potential. So, in figure A, you can see the depletion region between N and P type semiconductor. In figure B, here you can see the electrostatic potential, how this one is changing. So, with respect to Fermi level, we are calculating in N side how much is the electrostatic potential and how much is in the P side. And in figure C, you can see the charge distribution. And if you see here, we have the transient region, and to calculate this density, approximately we can take the rectangular distribution. Here you can see in the figure D, the unique space charge distribution and the electrostatic potential are given by the Poisson equation. Here you can see the equation. So, d square psi upon dx square, here psi is the electrostatic potential, this one is depend on the charge density, and epsilon s is the permittivity of semiconductor. For the neutral region, we can simplify d square psi upon dx square is equal to 0, and now the charge density nd minus na plus p minus n is equal to 0. For a p type neutral region, we assume nd is equal to 0 and hole concentration is very high compared to the electron concentration. The electrostatic potential of p type neutral region with respect to the Fermi level designed as psi p equal to minus 1 upon q ei minus ef, and this one is equal to minus kT upon Q ln Na upon Ni, and here P equal to Na, and we can use our basic Hall's concentration equation. By using this one, we can calculate the electrostatic potential in P side semiconductor. Similarly, we can obtain the electrostatic potential of N type neutral region with respect to the Fermi level. So, here psi p is in p side with respect to the Fermi level, and psi n is the electrostatic potential in n side semiconductor with respect to the Fermi level. So, here we can write psi n equal to minus 1 upon q ei minus ef, and again we can relate with carrier concentration. So, this will come minus kT upon q ln nd upon ni. And now we can calculate the total electrostatic potential. Here this one is given by VBI, this one is also called the built in potential. So, VBI equal to psi n minus psi p equal to kT upon q ln Na nd upon ni square. So, here Na and nd are doping of acceptors and donors, Ni is the intrinsic carrier concentration. So, at the junction, built-in potential is depending on the doping, and here in this figure, you can see the electrostatic potential as a function of doping in silicon and gallium arsenide. If you are increasing the doping level, here electrostatic potential also will increase. For a given doping concentration, the electrostatic potential of gallium arsenide is higher because of its smaller intrinsic carrier concentration Ni. Now, we will talk about the depletion region, how much is the depletion width and how is the electric field distribution. So, to calculate this one, in depletion region, electron and holes concentration are 0. So, the Poisson equation here we can write d square psi upon dx square equal to q upon epsilon s Na minus Nd. Let us consider an abrupt junction and the space charge distribution of an abrupt junction is shown below here. So now we can write this piezo equation for p side and n side. So here we can write d square psi upon dx square is equal to q Na upon epsilon. And here x limit x vary from minus xp to 0, and we can write d square psi upon dx square equal to minus q nd upon epsilon s, and here x changes from 0 to xn, and in the figure you can see the depletion width is from minus xp to xn. The overall space charge neutrality of the semiconductor require total positive charges is equal to total negative charges, and here we can write NaXp is equal to NdXn, and the depletion width is W equal to Xp plus Xn. And now we can calculate the electric field. This one is related to electrostatic potential. So here if you will integrate the piezo equation, we will get the electric field, and we can write Ex equal to minus d psi upon dx, and here you can see on the screen the equation. Similarly, we will get for from 0 to xn and from minus xp to x these two equations. And if we will draw these equations, we get this our electric field is from positive charges to the negative charges, and the maximum electric field we can write Em equal to q nd xn upon epsilon s equal to q na xp upon epsilon s. So by using this one we can calculate the maximum electric field, and if you draw this electric field here in figure A, you can see the charge distribution. In figure B, you can see the electric field distribution. So here electric field is from N side to P side, from positive charges to negative charges. And here you can see the electric field distribution. This one is linearly changes with the x axis. The total potential variation, here we can calculate how much is the our built-in potential. So VBI we can integrate from minus xp to xn, and by using this electric field we can calculate, and this will be q na xp square upon 2 epsilon s plus q nd xn square upon 2 epsilon s, and this one is equal to the total area in figure B. This one is by using the triangle we can calculate. This one here is equal to 1 by 2 here Em W, and W is the depletion width. So here we can rewrite this equation, and we can write depletion width W is equal to square root of 2 epsilon s upon q Na plus Nd upon Na Nd VBI. So by using this one we can calculate the depletion width. So this one is depending on the carrier concentration and built-in potential. Again, built-in potential is also depending on the doping concentration. So here depletion width is depending on carrier concentration, how much is the doping in N side and how much is the doping in P side. Now if you will take one special case, in this one side dead abrupt junction. So in one side we have very high doping and another side we have low level doping. So in this case our depletion width will be only in N side. Here you can see in the figure A. In figure B you can see the charge distribution, figure C you can see the electric field distribution, and figure D you can see the electrostatic potential. So here our depletion width W is equal to xn, and this one is the square root of 2 epsilon s VBI upon q n d, because here any carrier concentration, this one is greater than n d carrier concentration. And again, we can calculate the electric field. We can calculate the maximum electric field. Here you can see on the screen. And here maximum electric field is depending on lightly doped bulk concentration. Now we will come on the depletion capacitance. This one is also called the junction capacitance. So if we are changing the voltage, how our capacitance is changing here? So the depletion layer capacitance per unit area is defined Cj equal to dq upon dv, where dq is the incremental charge per unit area as for an incremental charge per unit voltage. So here in figure A you can see the depletion width. Now if you are applying some voltage, if you are changing this one, increasing or decreasing, our here in the depletion region charge will also change, and again charge is related here to the electric field. So we can calculate here the junction capacitance, and this one is depend on here Cj equal to epsilon s upon w. W is the depletion width. So basically we can say here capacitance is depending on the depletion width. If you are increasing or decreasing, our capacitance also will change with the depletion width. And here on the screen you can see the relationship between capacitance and the depletion width. Now if you will apply some bias on our diode, how the built-in potential and energy band diagrams are changing. On the screen you can see the three different conditions. First one is the thermal equilibrium, second one is the forward bias. When we have applied the forward bias, here the built-in potential, this one is reduced by Q VBI minus VF. If you are applying the reverse bias, our barrier here, this one is increased by Q VBI plus VR. So if you are applying in the forward bias, depletion width is decreased. If you are applying reverse bias, our depletion width is increased. Now I will come on current voltage characteristic of diode. At thermal equilibrium, the majority carrier density in the neutral region is essentially equal to the doping concentration, and the expression for the built-in potential we can write VBI equal to KT upon Q ln PP0 NN0 upon NI square. Here PP0 is the hole concentration in p-type semiconductor, and 0 is indicating the thermal equilibrium. NN0 is the electron concentration in n-type semiconductor in thermal equilibrium. And here we can rewrite these equations, and we can use our here NN0 equal to NP0 exponential Q VBI upon KT. Similarly for holes, you can see on the screen. When a forward bias is applied, now the electrostatic potential, this will change. This will be the here VBI minus VF for the forward bias, and for the reverse bias, this will be VBI plus VR. So now our electron and hole concentration will change. So here we can write this one. Now our electron concentration in n-type semiconductor, this one is changed. In the thermal equilibrium, the electron concentration was NN0. Now when we have applied bias, this will be the NN equal to NP exponential Q VBI minus V upon KT. And if we will talk about the low level injection means the injected carrier concentration is very small compared to the doping concentration, and the majority carrier's concentration is not changing with this low level injection. So here we can write this one NP equal to NP0 exponential QV upon KT. And now how much change is there in our carrier concentration, in the minority carrier concentration? This we can write NP minus NP0. So here NP is the minority carrier concentration when we have applied the bias, and NP0 is in thermal equilibrium. And here this minority carrier concentration, this one is related to the applied bias. And similarly we can calculate for holes in n-type semiconductor. and this will be Pn minus Pn0 is equal to Pn0 exponential qv upon kt minus 1. So by using these equations, we can calculate the minority carrier concentration. And here in figure A, you can see the minority carrier distribution in forward bias. In figure B, you can see the energy band diagram and minority carrier distribution in reverse bias. So here first we have calculated at the junction at xn and at minus xp the minority carrier concentration, and with distance how this one is changing. By using the continuity equation, we can calculate. On screen you can see the continuity equation. In the neutral n region, there is no electric field, thus the state continuity equation reduced to d square pn upon dx square minus pn 0 upon dp tau p is equal to 0. Here tau p is the mean free time of Hall's, and the solution of this equation you can see on the screen. From this minority carrier distribution, we can calculate the current, and on the screen you can see the Hall's current Jp is equal to minus q dp dpn upon dx, and from this one we can calculate the Hall's current density. And similarly we obtain for the neutral p region the electron current density. And now if you will draw these minority carrier distribution and current components, here in figure A you can see the junction is in forward bias, in B the junction is in reverse bias, and we have the different component. So here we have calculated current at the junction at minus xp and xn, we have added, and this total current is J. So now our total current J, this one is constant in the device, and we have calculated current component due to diffusion. The remaining part is the drift part. So here total our current is constant in the forward bias and in the reverse bias. In the reverse bias, current conduction is very small. And now the total current is constant throughout the device. So here you can see the diode equation, J equal to Jp plus Jn, and this one is equal to Js exponential qv upon kt minus 1. This one is called the diode equation. Here Js is the saturation current density, and this one is depending on the minority carrier concentration at the junction. And if you will draw this equation, here you can see the current voltage diagram. So in the forward bias, current conduction is very high, and in the reverse bias, current conduction is very small. So diode allow the current conduction in one direction, and this will oppose in the opposite direction. So we can use for the rectifier applications. Now I will come on avalanche breakdown. So here in left hand side figure, you can see the current voltage characteristic. Now if you will apply very high voltage in the reverse bias, now the current here you can see after a certain voltage, this will drastically increase here, and this one is called reverse breakdown current. Thick depletion region create the high electric field. And now if some electron or hole will come in this high electric field, this electron will collide with another atom and create the here another electron and hole. Here in the right hand side figure you can see the electron here, due to this high electric field, electron collided with the atom and created another electron and hole. Now hole will move in the opposite direction, this will again collide and will create the another electron hole, and this multiplication process will continue, and we will get the very high current in reverse bias, and this one is called the avalanche breakdown. The another phenomena which is called Zener breakdown, When heavily doped junction is reverse biased, the energy band become crossed at relatively low voltage. Here you can see in the figure A, we have the energy band diagram, and our P and N both are heavily doped. If the barrier separating these two bands is narrow, tunneling of electrons can occur. The tunneling of electron from P side to N side will generate a high reverse current. In figure B, you can see the conduction band of N-type semiconductor is below the valence band of P-type semiconductor. So now electrons will tunnel through this barrier from P side to N side, and the in reverse bias, our current will drastically increase, and this phenomena is called the Zener effect. By using this one, we can make the Zener diode, and we can use for different application to save the circuit. In this part of lecture, we have discussed about depletion layer formation, space charge and electric field distribution. We have also derived the depletion width and junction capacitance, minority carrier distribution and current voltage characteristic of diode. We have also discussed the Zener and avalanche breakdown mechanism. I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. Thank you very much.